we have with us Naveen Patel of Affine. He's the TA head of Affine. He's joined us here today to share his thoughts on this topic and help us learn from his experience. We've also got Anand Kumar from Sense. Hello, gentlemen. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Yeah, Kash.
All right. So let's look at some simple housekeeping notes before we get started. Now, first of all, we love questions here at Sense in our webinars. So if you've got questions, you'll see a small Q&A box there. Feel free to flood that box with questions. We'll answer all your questions in the end. We've got 15 minutes saved just for that. So whether it's related to technology, if you want product suggestions, or if you want any doubts about the use cases that we suggest, please go ahead and ask us questions. We'll be happy to clarify that below. And yes, this will happen in the last 15 minutes. We also have this webinar being recorded. So it's okay if your friend missed it, if somebody in your company couldn't attend, we'll be sending everybody who signed up for this webinar a recording of the webinar. All right. Before we get started, before we dive into this topic, I want to go ahead and make some introductions. Right. First off, I'm going to talk about Naveen Patel, who's taking time out today to share his expertise with us today. Now, as you all know, Naveen Patel is right now the global TA head at Affine, right? He's an expert in this domain, and he's got over two decades of experience, and he's an innovative strategist who's risen to the ranks in a very diverse organization, a global organization. Thank you, Naveen, for being with us here today. It's going to be very, very exciting to hear what you've got to say.
Yeah, Akash.
And as you all know, Anand leads the revenue organization for the India business at Sense, whether it's sales, marketing. Anand takes care of all of it. And all of you would also know that the company, right, recently Skillet was acquired by Sense. It's now a merged entity, right? I'm going to go ahead and give you a little bit of information about Sense so that you have an understanding. So Sense was founded about 7 years ago in the US, and it had a primary focus on building a talent engagement platform which can be used by staffing companies and corporates to streamline their talent engagement, help them engage efficiently, and in the process, enhance overall candidate experience. Today, Sense has over 1,000 customers globally and over 40,000 recruiters log into this platform on a monthly basis every morning to check out their hires and recruit faster, right? In 2022, we powered over 2 million hires for our customers around the globe. And it really helps that we are SOC2 compliant, which shows that we're really committed towards security and data protection for our customers globally. As you can see here, we are backed by Titan investors like Avatar, Google, and many others. And last year, we raised our Series B fund with SoftBank, right? And let's talk a little bit about Skillet. Skillet, which is now a Sense company. The reason we made this acquisition was because it was a great synergy, right? One, they offered us an amazing head start in the Indian market. And second, they came with an amazing product and an amazing group of individuals who make it happen, right? So today, Sense and Skillet have over 15 unicorns in India, who we call as customers, and a bunch of other huge legacy companies who've been in India for a long time, who also use Skillet for their recruiting day-to-day, on a day-to-day basis. This includes many Nifty 50 companies. All right. And then I'm going to talk a little bit about Affine here. So Affine is a leading AI and analytics engineering consulting and solutions firm. Now, they offer capabilities across the analytical value chain, across multiple verticals and business functions, right? They're a huge team. They're based all over the world, mostly North America and India, and they are dedicated to enabling global enterprises to transform and innovate through the power of AI, engineering, and cloud technologies. So that is Affine for you. And we're going to go ahead and get started right now. Anand, I'm going to give it to you, hand the mic over to you to go ahead and start this conversation with Naveen.
Thanks, Akash, for setting up this context. Hello, everyone from the audience. I'm Anand, Head of Business Operations for Sense India. As highlighted by Akash, we are headquartered in US, having significant presence in US and Europe. As a part of this acquisition, we are together in this product journey, how we can help our customers, right? So thanks, Naveen, for taking out time and spending some time with our people who want to learn more on what exactly we are doing with our customers, right? So to the larger audience, what I've done is Naveen is using our product from some time now, and I'll be keep focusing on some actual aspect, right? What Naveen was doing, is doing, and will be doing as the part of recruitment process, and definitely the learnings that he has in his experience. And as a format, what we have done is going to ask a couple of questions one by one in sequence so that Naveen can answer all of that from his experience. And in the meanwhile, as said by Akash, whoever wants to ask any particular aspect, either from Naveen or from me, please feel free to do so in the Q&A section. We'll try to pull in as and when required, or definitely at the last of the conversation. So I'm just going ahead, Naveen. If you want to just say it to Lino, to say hi, and then I'll start.
Sure, Anand. It's an honor to be here in this particular webinar today.
Thank you. Right, I'm just starting up. So first of all, the audience would like to know a bit about Afine as a business, right? Although Akash explained it, but nobody can explain better than you the kind of offerings and the company that Afine is and operate at.
Sure. So to start off, you know, Afine is a 12-year-old organization which was founded in 2011. So we are a purely data analytics consulting firm. And, you know, we are a digital transformation partner and expert in AI, data engineering, cloud, and having, you know, domain expertise in gaming, high-tech, manufacturing, and CPG. And, you know, like it was mentioned in the slide, you know, we have more than 400 employees based out of various office locations like Bangalore, Hyderabad, multiple locations in US, Singapore, and the UK. And, you know, we also assist more than 45 Fortune 100, 500 clients, right? So they are our partners, and we also help them in our sole mission of enabling our customers to command the new. And with respect to our offerings, you know, we offer anything starting from data insights to transformation. And that includes cloud advisory, assessment, cloud migration, data lake design, development, or anything to do with, you know, architectural design. So that's what we do at Afine.
Great to know, Naveen, right? So a lot of heavy lifting on the data and insightful things that you and your team does, right, to support some of the large businesses at a global scale. So let's start quickly focusing on the agenda, right? Because here, whether you, me, or anybody else are from somehow related with HR or be specific recruiting, right? So tell us a bit about the recruitment team at Afine and what kind of roles you typically hire for within your organization.
So I have a team of 15 people, and they manage a complete hiring, right? Be it offshore hiring, on-site hiring. So they take care of the complete hiring part. And you know, we work on very you know, complex roles, right? The kind of requirement that we have, the kind of difference that we bring to our customers, right? The value. So we work on those kind of roles, right? Which are related to data analytics, and it could be within data science, AI, ML, data engineering, business analytics, or a little bit of, you know, full stack front end and back end development. And then we also work on certain domain expertise, you know, to ensure that we are being relevant to the market, industry, and working on cutting edge technologies.
So you hire the best of the best then, right, in the industry and the world. And definitely, really, really great to know the kind of hiring that you do as an organization. So now, if I'll be very specific about Skillet Sense, right, your team has been using it, the product, for a long time. We are currently in a challenging hiring market, and recruiting teams everywhere are being asked to do more with less, right? Can you tell us how Sense has been helping your team do more with less? Are there any specific features that have helped your recruiters complete core tasks faster or even in a more efficient manner? Because at this point of time, I believe it's all about efficiency, productivity, right? What, how much we can do more with less?
Sure. I think we've been using Sense for almost 18 months. And then we've also been able to bring in at least 30 to 40% efficiency from the erstwhile ATS that we are using. So that's a clear gain that we can see. At the same time, there's a lot of automation that Sense has brought in. We have more control on the data, more control on the process that we have. Also, we get a lot of customization option on Skillet, right? Which I did not see that happening on other platform. So here we have a lot of freedom that we can do it on our own. And I think the major areas where we have been able to benefit is the job description, right? The GD Analyzer platform, which tells us whether GD is good or not good, right? And getting the GD right is very important, right? And especially when you're putting it out in the market. And obviously, we get a lot of applications. So I think the other feature that Sense has really helped us in, AI feature of being able to give a score for a particular candidate against a job description. So I think this is something which is good. At the same time, there are also features where we can customize our weightage. So if I want to focus more on skill sets, then I put more weightage on that. And then basis that, I get a revised score of a particular candidate. Or if I want to focus more on years of experience or on education parameters. So it also allows me to do that particular customization to ensure that I'm not losing my time in talking to hundreds of candidates, but talking to the top 10, top 15, top 20 candidates and getting a better success match relevancy out of there. I think that's a challenge for the entire recruitment industry of the top funnel, right? How do you filter that particular funnel from maybe hundreds of candidates to getting the top 10 candidates that you invest time in and get the best results?
Really appreciate it, Naveen, right? So to the larger audience also, the moment you post a job, you get hundreds of applicants or sometimes even thousands of applicants, right? So how and what exactly we can do by leveraging AI is one thing that companies definitely expect and what we have been able to deliver. So UI use, right? So I think now let's move into the poll. So we are going to have a quick poll for the audience to find out how much AI and automation you are using every day. So the question is, are you using any of these technologies at your company to get more done with less? Akash, can you please help?
All right, the poll is coming up. Give us a second. And you can see the poll right now on your screen. Is it visible?
Yes.
We'll give the audience about a minute to go ahead and fill this in. All right, the answers are coming in. We'll give it about 10 more seconds. Can we get at least 50% participation, folks? Go ahead and answer the poll on your screen. Just click on the ones that you actually use. Okay, I think we can go ahead and. Okay, there are a few responses still coming in. We can go ahead and end it in a second, I believe. All right. Let's look at the results. Can you all see the results on your screen? All right.
Yes. Great. Thanks, audience, for the participation. Right. I believe that what makes us feel happy about the kind of use cases people expect, right? Be it AI, be it blockchain, be it LLMs, how and what can be leveraged at any recruitment pieces. So I think I'm just going ahead. Naveen, so your team at Affine was using a different ATS in the past. What shortcomings made you start looking around for an alternative? And why Sense appealed to you during your search?
Sure. So I think the main concern that we had was around user friendliness, right? The portal was lacking all the latest features. It was lacking integration capabilities. It lacked automation, end to end in the process, right? And even the reporting was not easily customizable and not giving us the right output. And that was the reason why I was, prompted to look out for a different platform. were evaluated about, you know, about 5 to 6 different platforms during that time. But what appealed to me about Sense was it was very customizable. It had all the features that I wanted, you know, starting from JD creation to the time, till the time a document is collected and offer is released, you know, with a candidate. And also wanted to automate the employee referral process that was completely manual. So Sense was giving me all those kind of features, right? All the latest features that anyone would expect as a TA leader. And also, you know, that I could see value for money for this particular product, right? So that was something differentiated. And also the customer success team was very, very helpful in, you know, extending the support, understanding our challenges, and also taking a lot of requirements that I had, you know, expectation from the Skillet platform. And those requests were, you know, eventually taken up and I could see them, you know, being incorporated. So what else as a TA leader would you expect, right? You know, you tell something, you know, this is what you wish and that comes true on the platform. So I think that was one of the main reasons why, you know, I thought Sense was the best platform for my company.
Thanks, Naveen. So if I'll summarize, it was definitely the experience, right? So product experience, be it UI, UX, then definitely the configuration that you look up to, and then the customer success and support, right? What kind of information we are being gathered. So I think one of the important aspect is for all of us to understand, right? It's never one size fit all. So I believe how much platform can be configured at a company level in terms of their hierarchy, the department, the location configuration, all possible configuration that a company look up to is one thing which is extremely important in nature. And definitely we have tried our best to make this entire product that much configurable so that it suits the business needs, what a company typically looks out for. So yeah. Thanks for that. I'll just go ahead and talk about, I believe, AI, right? So everyone in every field is talking about AI today. Are there any ways in which your team at Affine is using AI to enhance your hiring process?
So I think definitely Sense is a big platform for us where we use AI and automation, which helps us, you know, complete in the process, right? In terms of giving us the data or maybe chatbot screening or auto scheduling, you know, a lot of automation that the tool is providing. Or if the best part I liked was in terms of being able to put a posting on a social media, right? Just with a click of a button on a mobile or on a laptop, right? So that's something which is very, very convenient, which is there. And obviously, we also start leveraging the OpenAI, right? Like ChatGPT, which basically, example, if I have to do a posting on LinkedIn for a particular job description, I just take the job description from the platform, you know, take help of ChatGPT to curate it, make it more you know, what to say, attractive, and then I post it on LinkedIn. So I think that's where we leverage ChatGPT also, you know, for our processes and ensuring that, you know, whatever assistance we can get, you know, it helps the entire team.
Thanks, Naveen, for this. To the larger audience, we have implemented this Gen AI capability, right? What Naveen was just highlighting around 2 months before, because I believe there is a lot of buzz going on in the market, right? What is going to happen with all these LLMs coming together? I'm not sure whether it's good, it's bad, it's biased, whether our data is getting compromised, etc., etc. But what we thought is, rather than just having any other faith, right, let's implement in our software, on our platform, so that we can see and start playing around with that platform, right? And start using the good part of it so that we are very, very well versed with what exactly is happening behind the scene. So definitely this helps the larger portion of people to whom we are working with. So the next is, even though we are in a challenging hiring market today, right? Quality candidates are still picking up multiple offers from different companies. So one of my mentors long time back said that it was never like candidates were less or more, right? It was always, is always, and will always be that good candidates will be in lesser quantity, right? You will hardly find a good candidate. So on that front, how can recruiters provide candidates with a good hiring experience so that their brand becomes the top choice against competitors? Because Naveen, the kind of hiring that you're doing, right? So for candidates also, there are plenty of options. So why Affine and how you are doing that on a daily practice?
Okay, that's a good question, Anand. So what we do is, you know, I always tell the recruiters to be agile, to be, you know, more personalized experience for the candidate. Right. Well, I've seen in the past experience, you know, we kind of put some processes in place and ask our recruiters to, you know, follow that process, you know, without any particular, you know, using any intelligence of their own, right? So that is something which I discourage. I ask my team to be very creative, try to, you know, figure out, you know, what is the candidate's expectation, whether he's already holding an offer or what is his interest level in a particular opportunity, or if he's a passive candidate and if you're trying to attract him for an opportunity, right? So that's a, you know, customized messaging that has to be given for a particular candidate versus someone who's already applied with, about, you know, to Affine. So someone who's already applied will definitely know more about Affine and already showing his interest, right? So then you will have to engage him in a different manner compared to one who is very passive. So what we do is we ensure that any of our tech-based platforms that we have there, tech assessment platform or anything where we have to engage our candidates, right? So we ensure that that is user-friendly. Because at the end of the day, it is a reflection of our company, even though those are external platforms for us. But because, you know, it represents Affine, it's important that they are user-friendly and they're able to utilize that particular platform. So that's how I look at that particular platform. And from an internal process standpoint, I always don't look at automating 100%, right? The moment you 100%, you're losing that human touch element. And that is very, very important to us in differentiating between what a, you know, a robot can do and what a human can do. And that's where I ensure that every touch point is important. Example, the interviewer has to introduce themselves, you know, talk about Affine, be on camera. You know, these are some of the small things we have to ensure that the candidate gets a consistent experience throughout the process. And we also have a post-offer engagement program where we assign them a pre-joining buddy. We have someone connecting, you know, from the project team, someone connecting from the recruitment team to ensure that 30, 60, 90 days of notice period that they're serving, there's someone contacting them and available. And we also have a common email ID and every email, every, you know, activity that we do to ensure that the person is able to reach to an ID where he will get, he or she will get a response. So that's the kind of focus we have on candidate experience.
Definitely, Naveen. I think, and what is super important is how technology can work hand in hand with people, right? Let technology do their own work. But the, exactly rightly said, the way you have said it, right? We want it to be personalized. We want to be human-centric rather than machine-centric. And this is super important that what we humans should do as a kind of quality job to make that touch feeling with the person that, hey, we are here and we are caring for you, right? Nobody wants any surprise being in the recruitment team. So how to avoid the surprises is till the time you're not getting connected with the person that, yes, why you are so important for us at, as of today, right? And if there are surprises, tell me. If you can't tell me, I can't help. So I think rather than having the surprise at the last moment, right, which nobody likes. I believe a lot of our audience also can relate to this problem statement. I'm just going ahead. So I believe this has happened in the last couple of months, right, as a sorry to say, but depending on the macroeconomics factor, specifically for people and companies who are dependent on North America region. Now in a weak hiring market, recruiters sometimes feel a little lost. Their company might have slowed down hiring or even declared a hiring freeze, right? So what can recruiting leaders work on these challenges time to demonstrate their value and expertise to the rest of the business?
I think this is, you know, if you take it positively in terms of, you know, low hiring volume, right? It is basically a time for the recruiting leaders and the recruitment team to basically look at certain tasks or activities that probably could have taken a backseat, right? When the volumes are high, there's a lot of demand, a lot of pressure from the business, you start prioritizing what is important to them, right? So I think that is the time, this is the time when we can focus on other things, right? I think what I had done is, you know, spending more time with the team, right? Because they need someone who will building that, you know, confidence, you know, boosting their morale or giving them that particular support, guidance, right, during these low hiring times. And what I also focus on this in terms of upskilling the teams on, you know, best practices within the industry, talking to, you know, different job platform partners to see if they can do a refresher session on the latest features, you know, that these, you know, the recruiters can use. Engaging better with the team, right, in terms of maybe having more fun connects compared to what we could do during regular times, encouraging my team to, you know, take vacation time off, right? Because if they wanted a week or 2 weeks of vacation, I think, you know, this is the best time that I could have approved, right, without any concern. And then we also, you know, what people can do is, you know, do brainstorming along with the team, right? Because This is a time when people can, share some out of the box ideas that can be debated further within the group, right? We can slice it, we cannot do just one brainstorming session and, we eat all, right? So we have to break down a particular process, right? Or maybe ask the team in terms of what are the topmost pain points that they have and pick up that point and then debate saying that what can be done differently. And the other thing that they can do is revisiting existing processes and then figure out if there are any areas where you can streamline it further and try to gain efficiency for them. And also, I spent some time in, meeting some business stakeholders, leaders, trying to understand the context, what the business is doing, right? To understand that in terms of connect. So that's something which I did. We also kind of standardized, job descriptions, figuring out the kind of role that we do, how can we create, specific screening questionnaires where we can improve our quality at the time of, sourcing and at the same time of putting them through the interview. So we even created a standard job description, also encouraged my recruiters to go on LinkedIn, increase the, the connection that they have with the candidates, right? For the kind of role that they are hiring. I think that's something, which we did. And as TA leaders, we should, I also went through a lot of tool demos, for different technologies, different platforms that are in the market, just to understand how the market is coming up and if there is any particular tools that we can leverage, for our hiring the moment the hiring volume picks up. Spend some time in vendor engagement, talking to vendors, meeting them in person, trying to, reestablish those connects that were there. Also spend some time in, attending events, seminars, building my network. And also trying to understand the current market trend and best practices, from the industry.
Really thanks, Naveen, for this, right? So this is to everybody. If the hiring is stopped, it does not mean that it's stopped forever. And what matters is, can you invest this time today within yourself, within your team, so that once the time comes, you can do really, really well there, right? So I think this is the summary of, I believe, what Naveen wanted to say, and how to be prepared for that time is extremely important today and not tomorrow. Tomorrow, not the business. The business is not going to tell that in 90 days, if you have to do 100 positions, right? How you're going to do that? Because in last 90 days, you have done 5. And there was no mistake of this team because the business was not like that. But the, how to match the expectation once the time comes up and goes up is something which is significantly important for the stakeholders that we are talking about. I hope I'm resonating with majority of the folks who are out there here as the part of this call. So I'm going ahead, Naveen. Most recruiters, when they think about hiring, they think about job platforms, specifically like Naukri, right? But these are good. What are other platforms out there where people should feel and go, definitely? For example, many amazing candidates who are passive, definitely one is LinkedIn, but other platforms like GitHub, etc. Would love to hear the importance of all these parallel platforms that has come up, specifically for the hiring that you do.
Yeah, so I think this is basically required. Like, we have GitHub, we have Stack Overflow, right? These are for developers and IT experts in the market. But I think these are ones where you are maybe looking for a specific kind of a person, right? The profile that the business wants is very specific in terms of the kind of skill sets. They want a rock star kind of a material, or they want someone with a particular, specific domain. I think that is the time when you have to invest in platforms like GitHub or Stack Overflow, where you can go and maybe look at the kind of coding a person is doing, the kind of profile the person has got, right? So you cannot literally target them like a job, a portal platform, but you can get the details of these people and then try to find them on LinkedIn and then try to connect with them and then try to attract them. So it is more of giving you a sense of a particular person. If I look at a person's resume, it could be beautifully presented, but we don't know the content or the kind of profile it is, right? And these kind of platforms talk about the quality, they talk about the kind of coding they're doing, the kind of activity they're doing, the kind of company that they're working with. Or if you're targeting a particular company, then you can look at the kind of developers that are there on this platform from those companies, and they'll be easier for you to attract and figure out, right? So your success and hit ratio is higher. At the same time, you're able to passively look at it. But obviously, you have to invest time in this. You cannot directly go and approach someone or, for a purpose of a job, because they may not even be looking at it, right? So you have to kind of engage them in a different platform and then see how to attract them, convince them about a particular role. So I can suggest, you know, GitHub and Stack Overflow for these kind of roles. And there's a site called Medzilla for healthcare professionals where you can also do some postings. And if you're looking at profiles for UX or UI or designers, right, then you can go to sites like Behance and Dribbble, where you can look at people's portfolios, figure out the kind of work that they've done. And you can also look at that and probably share it with the hiring manager, saying that this is the kind of profile that I have, you know, would you be interested? So when they kind of shortlist some people, and then you can, you know, try to talk to them, reach out to them, you know, and then attract them to the organization. And then I've seen some people doing postings. If it's a maybe a bulk requirement, I think Insta, Facebook, you know, these are the different social media, some of the recruiters that, you know, invest time in. At least it will help in talent branding if we're not able to attract the relevant candidates.
Right. So I think it's all about networking, right? So you have to network with all sets of people so that once you have the requirement, you can talk to them. Because today, hiring actively and hiring passively, we have to combine both depending on the requirement that we have, depending on the skill that we have to hire, depending on the pace that we have to hire. So I believe, and this is to everybody, right? So if we can have the strong network of people, right, to whom we are going to interact with at any point of time, irrespective of the fact that whether I'm going to hire this person immediately within the organization or I'm going to pitch in about this particular role to this particular person as of today, right? We just feel like we are like-minded people and I'd love to be interacted with you is what I believe is the need of the hour, how we want to engage talent. So I'll just go ahead again about some interesting conversation. Many of your team members, Naveen, have told me that you are an AI enthusiast. So my next question is about ChatGPT specifically, because these days no discussion is truly complete without a question about LLMs, large language models.
Right. Yeah, so, you know, we definitely use it. So, you know, I wanted to be the first person to use it. So at the moment I heard about this hype in the, you know, in the news everywhere. So I was very curious in that, you know, what are the people are talking about and the kind of postings that were coming in or the news that were coming in floating. So that's when I decided to, you know, experience ChatGPT firsthand, right? And obviously initially I was just doing a trial, you know, asking maybe ChatGPT to give me a, you know, itinerary to a particular place or 10-day itinerary. So just trying to play around and see what kind of response I was getting. And it was quite surprising, you know, within seconds it was able to give me a, you know, itinerary and planning it entire for 10 days to a particular location, right? So I was bored with that particular thing. And that's when I started playing around more in terms of, you know, improving the content, right? If I have a particular job description, which I got maybe in 5 liners for a particular role for a years of experience. So I fed that into ChatGPT and told ChatGPT, can you make me a, you know, comprehensive job description? And it was able to do it, right? I would say it is at least 90-95% right. Maybe there are some points that we have to definitely use our human intelligence, right? And I would request everyone to please use human intelligence. Do not blindly take the output from ChatGPT and use it anywhere, because it's not 100% fit. That's the reason, please use that part and then utilize the content. So, you know, that's how I started using. I even, you know, revised or, you know, all the email draft that I had on, you know, Sense platform. I kind of used the existing ones and try to put it on ChatGPT to enhance it, seeing that, you know, whether I'm getting a better version, and wherever I got a better version, or maybe just a better sentence, right? I kind of incorporated that. So that's something which I did, you know, comprehensively for that. Then I also started experimenting one level further in terms of if I'm getting a job description, I'm getting a, you know, candidate resume, can ChatGPT tell me whether it's what kind of match it is? Right? And it started showing me results in that, you know, we find this to be a good match or a partial match. And it sometimes, even if you ask that to give a scoring pattern, it also tells you what kind of method it's using at the back end to arrive at a particular result. So, you know, I just did a search in the morning, right, for AM developer role, right? And it told me that this candidate is 52.5% fit, right? And this is the reason why, you know, we find it to be fit, you know. So it as a recruiter who are not very technical in nature, at least it gives them guidance in that which direction this profile is, you know, going ahead. Or if I, as a recruiter, feel that profile is good and ChatGPT complements it, then we at least know that, you know, both are in the right direction. So that was another use case of ChatGPT, and then also creating quick job posting, which I can do on LinkedIn, right? So I just give the content, tell them, give me a 5 bulleted points, you know, which I can post it on LinkedIn and the recommended hashtag. So ChatGPT does that also in terms of recommending those hashtag. And the other thing which I told the recruitment team is to also look at ChatGPT in terms of understanding technology better, understanding skills better, understanding alternate skills which are related to the skill, right? So it also tells you saying that this is alternate skill that you can look at instead of one particular skill. So for example, there is something called Kotlin and Swift UI, right? So there is a particular job description which said they wanted Kotlin in iOS, right? So when I kind of queried on ChatGPT, it said Android and Kotlin are related, and iOS and Swift UI are related. So that's when I went back to hiring manager, please reconfirm whether you're looking at this combination, then definitely not going to happen. So it kind of educates you once in a while where you're able to figure that out right front, because I was not getting in matches when I was doing on the search criteria. So that was one of the things.
Right.
Yeah.
Phenomenal, right? So I think that's how you leverage technology for your use cases on a daily operational activities, right? This should be really, really insightful for anybody and everybody who is there on call today and will listen to us as a recording later, right? Some of the small things which people might not be using as of date, but would love to leverage this kind of functionality, right, to help you optimize the day better. It's not just about writing emails better, if I can summarize in one line. Am I correct, Naveen?
That's right, Anand. That's actually more that ChatGPT can do.
Definitely. So I believe we are just ending towards our webinar. So please feel free to ask any question in the Q&A section. I have the last one, Naveen, for you, and then we'll open up for our Q&A session. Today, different companies are using different levels of automation and AI in the recruiting process. What you say is the bare minimum level of automation required by a company, specifically in 2023. And tell us which tech tools and capabilities are a must-have for recruiting teams, and then few more that you believe are good to have, right? Obviously, this LLM model will come again, but would love to hear and experience what exactly are your thoughts on this.
I think ETS, which is basically giving us end-to-end platform, right? Where you don't have to work on multiple logins, multiple platforms, right? So a good ETS, which will give you, internal database and entire process can be set, configured in that. Something which is configurable at a customer's end. There are a lot of platforms in the market where you have to raise a request, probably they're chargeable, they take a lot of time to make those changes, or they are denied change that they'll not be able to make the change. So I think a customizable ATS, which has the latest features it has to offer, and also an ATS which is, enhancing, improving itself, every 3 months, 6 months with new updates. I think that is something which it has to live up to, right? Rather than creating one product which is on for next 3-4 years. And this particular ATS should be able to, parse resumes, which accurately be able to do, like I said, the, top funnel match in terms of the GD and the resume. And also like Sense can even tell me right now, which candidate is suitable for alternate jobs. So example, if I get to know that the job, I have enough pipeline or probably got, canceled, I'll be able to find out with a particular candidate, which are the other jobs that I can, utilize him rather than just dropping him, from the pipeline. So I think that's something which is definitely required. Integration capabilities with various platforms. If there are ATS platforms which are integrated with more popular, commonly used platforms in the market, I think that's a win-win situation, because then I don't necessarily have to log into those platforms to maybe trigger a text assessment or do a, external interviews. So these are some of the ones which can be done, or digitization of off letter, capability of, collecting documents from the candidates, chatbot screening, auto scheduling. I think these are some of the things that should be a must-have for a decent ATS in the market. And like good to have, like obviously you mentioned about LLM kind of features, or maybe having a, a post offer engagement kind of a model where it talks about joining predictability of a particular person, right? Basis the different touch points a person, the AI can do, with the candidate. I think that's something which definitely help. Something to do with more of proctoring or a bio or, voice metrics that can be captured to ensure that there are no proxy candidates, in the system. Like right from starting from the time of, processing a profile, something that can validate a person's identity, example, something in Google, look at an Aadhaar card or, ensure that, that validation takes place of a genuine candidate. and we are able to match the same candidate till the time of onboarding. I think that's something which will definitely help.
Great, great, Naveen. Thanks for this insight, right? So imagine a candidate wherein he was about to be hired, but another candidate got shortlisted, right? So what to do with this candidate? There is no mistake. And as recruiter also, we feel sometimes bad that no, let's say in this case, Anand was good, but somehow we have not been able to place him because we like Naveen, right? So I think what to do with Anand in this case. So I believe this is one very important use case which every recruiter faces day in and day out. So we have solved this problem really well on our platform. So first of all, I have seen one question from Sunil, which I would love to, or Naveen would love to answer first. And I'll request everybody to put some of their questions if they want to. So Naveen, it's really, really a pleasure talking to you as leaders who have hands-on experience and approach to prefer to deep dive into the depth of the teamwork. Thanks for sharing your wisdom and inspiring our audience to embrace a truly hands-on leadership. We are open for the question answer.
Okay, so you want me to answer the question that Sunil has asked?
Right, so I think...
So I think automation again would depend on what level of automation that is, right? So example, using of automation anywhere for very basic tasks, right? So in my experience also, we have used in terms of maybe triggering emails, triggering follow-up reminders for a particular candidate, right? There are certain automated tasks that could be automated. So I think that is something can be leveraged very easily. But if there are certain complex automation that needs to be done, then we have to figure out whether it is better to have it in a particular ETS or outside it. Because as a recruiter, the lesser number of platforms that will log in to do that work, I think it's best, right? The moment you have more platforms, they also get tired learning a new platform, right? So we have to see what is the automation, what is the need, and if that can be done in the backend automate, that is best. I think for that, we definitely need to have expertise within the organization who are aware of different automation platforms, right? So this is one of the platforms that we used my the past company, right? Where we were able to automate all the regular tasks where you just maybe put it in a particular file in a particular location and then run the particular automation and it will do it in seconds without any human dependency.
Thanks, Naveen, for asking this, what Sunil has asked. Anybody else? Akash? I think Akash is saying no, there are no more questions. So the only thing is, I'll say thanks, Naveen, once again. Akash, do you want to run a small survey?
Yes, once we end the webinar, all the audience members will get a small survey. Our request is it's a small 10-second survey. Please go ahead and just take a second. It's multiple choice. Fill it up and then log off. You'll see it in a few seconds as soon as we end the webinar.
Okay. Thanks, Naveen. Thank you very much. Thanks, audience, for having...
Thank you, Akash.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Anand.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.